Carson's bad year. Jalen's not good enough to win the job year. The new quarterback drafted high in the draft year. And the next year thereafter, because he's going to get a minimum of 2 years worth of, it could be four straight years of bad quarterback play for the Eagles. And here's another aspect that scares me. And sorry to say, Eagle fans, it should bother you and scare you too. If the year doesn't go well, if Jalen Hurts isn't good enough to project as you're starting going forward, and the Eagles have to use their pick, because, yes, the Eagles right now have a very good chance at having three first-round picks in this upcoming draft, I would be willing to bet good money that their own pick will be higher, as in coming earlier in the draft, than either the Dolphin pick or the Colt pick. But if they use it on a quarterback, they're more married to that guy. Remember, Jalen Hurts was taken mid to late second round. You give him a shot, doesn't work out, you got to move on. It's a loss, but it's not that big of a loss. When you take a guy in the top 10, top 8, top 5, depending on how bad the Eagles season really is, once you call out that quarterback name, he's going to get a shot. It's not going to be just a one-year and we'll flip it again and go quarterback again in the 2022 draft. No, they're going to give that guy a chance. They'll be willing to move on from Jalen Hurts going into his third year. They're not going to be willing to move on a quarterback taken in the top 6, 7, 8 draft overall after just 1 year. That's not happening. So they better get that one right, because we could be looking at some mediocre quarterback play for X amount years in a row. Carson's bad year. Jalen's not good enough to win the job year. The new quarterback drafted high in the draft year. And the next year thereafter, because he's going to get a minimum of 2 years worth of, it could be four straight years of bad quarterback play for the Eagles.
Yeah, it could be, Jody. You're right with what you said. Things have sped up. We've talked a lot about this, Mike Tannenbaum being the latest. Things have sped up when it comes to quarterback evaluation in this league. And you see it with Carson Wentz and Jared Goff, and before them, Jameis Winston, Marcus Mariota. The Jets are probably the best example. I mean, they're drafting top five with Sam Darnold. Then a couple years down the road, they're drafting top five again. So things have sped up, and people are willing to move on from the quarterback position a lot quicker than they used to be, but it's not going to be 1 year. So, yeah, if you make a mistake at that position, it's still a multiple year mistake before you can even think about moving on. And I don't know if that's good or not. But one thing where Mike Tannenbaum said, I disagree with, you know, he's talking about Joe Burrow and his NFL lack of an NFL body and his lower body not being powerful enough. And he would have wished that they kept Andy Dalton and sat Joe Burrow for a year. Look, Mike, I love you. You can't take a quarterback number one overall. He's getting on the field, especially if Andy Dalton's the bridge. Nobody's going to accept Andy Dalton picking the number one overall pick. So there's so much pressure to get these young quarterbacks on the field. Where Mike is completely right is a lot of them aren't ready, but nobody has the patience for the development of the quarterback position. And the problem, Jody, is when you take a guy that high, there's even more pressure to get him on the field.